evening. Yesterday I made a speech in the Commons, which had the whole House standing and applauding and cheering for 20 minutes. And I must admit, I had a strange choking feeling in my throat. Ted Heath was strangling me.
Rocky, tell me, what's the first thing you do when you get back to the dressing room?
Stop the bleeding.
Tell me, you fought Kid Johnson and you fought Kid Lewis.
I fought Kid Lewis and I fought Kid Johnson.
Then you fought Kid Berg.
Then I fought Kid Berg.
Then what happened?
Then I started losing.
Why?
I started fighting grown-ups.
I'll tell you one now right now when I first seen. Get out. I want to pray. I just want to do right now because I want to hear it. I want to shake my leg one more time because nobody's going to ever
hello.
Stop me.
Yeah, stop messing up. Hey, Mr. Parsley. You know, I saw your last film three times.
Really?
Yes, I couldn't find my shoes anywhere.
Hello, good evening and welcome. Tonight, I welcome that super, super, superstar, Mr. John Wayne. Mr. Wayne, is it true that you have the fastest draw in the movies?
It sure is. You go on, you can test me. I can draw my gun before you can say Jack Robinson.
Very well. Jack Robinson. Jack Robinson. Jack Robinson. Jack Robinson. Jack Robinson.
Could you try Engelbert Humperdinck?
Thanks a lot, baby. My name is Office President. One more time, shake my lip. And here we go again.
Hey, Mr. Parsley.
Yeah, baby.
I just saw your last film.
My latest?
No. You lost.
Guys and girls, how's about, you know a song now, and tell the boss, how's about the song now, the goddess of man, how's about, how's about, how's about, how's about, how's about, and again. Now, what about a song now?
Get down.
Now, what about a song now? How's about a beautiful song now from Cilla Black. Thank you, guys and girls.
Batman!
Yes, Robin, old chum?
We're 50 stories up. What if we fall?
Don't worry, youngster. My uncle once fell from 100 stories up and lived to tell about it.
He did, Batman?
Yes, he told the people on the 99th floor, the 98th floor, and the 97th floor, and the 96th floor.
Okay, children, watch the vulture.
Hey, everything's all set, okay? Okay? Everything's all set.
What do you mean? Set for what?
For the break, dummy. The break. The break. We're going over the wall, dummy. We're going over the wall. Are you with us?
No.
No? Why not?
Because I'm the water.
Hey, Marshall. Can you shut that door?
Who are you? Iroquois, Apache, Mohegan.
Me, Sioux.
Your tribe?
No, my name.
Sure.
Can I have a word with you?
Yep. What's on your mind, McClintock?
Somebody stole my horse 3 months ago.
Well, why didn't you report it before?
I didn't miss it until today.
Hello, tell me, my dear. What exactly were you doing?
on the night of September the 3rd, 1968.
Don't you remember?
Clerk of the court, did you get that down?
Yes, my lad.
Yes, well, rub it out immediately.
Oh, you are lawful. But I like you.
Ikawata imata wa on the paka wata hey.
You are.
Thank you very much indeed, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to say first thing I'm doing is shake my leg, my bone falls off again. Well, I gotta tell you something right now, because I'm gonna sing. I ain't gonna sing as well when John gets the scissors and cuts it like this. I'm gonna do it right now. And I don't care if it cuts me right off. How's John? I'd like to sing now my favorite song, my latest recording, and it goes something like this. Thanks, Sam.
I'm just an old fashioned girl, old fashioned mind. Some sophistication when I jut euch haven't wine. And an old-fashioned millionaire.
Thank you very much indeed.
And now, what about a goose? Oh!
friends, thank you tremendously. Thank you sincerely. Welcome once again to Opportunity Knox. Now, let's find out who our first sponsor is on the show here tonight. Let's give him a nice big round of applause. He's all the way from Liverpool. Come down here, old son. Tell me, old son, what is your name?
My name's Huey Green. I want to tell you very much indeed, Huey. My name's Huey.
Well, it's wonderful to have you on the show, Huey. Now,
yes, thank you very much indeed, Huey.
Now, tell me, old son, who is it? Who is it you're going to bring brought along on the show to introduce to us here tonight?
Well, Huey, we have a great friend of mine, a great friend of yours.
Well, we want to see him. We certainly do. What's his name, old son?
His name is Huey Green.
Huey Green. We certainly want to see him. Friends, here he is, Mr. Huey Green.
Well, hello, friends. Want to say how very happy we are to be here.
Here we are.
Well, nothing. I was looking out to double up so howls among them then. Now, it gives me great pleasure. Get down. It gives me great pleasure now to introduce that young man who swivels his hips, Mr. Elvis Presley.
Hello, Honky Tonk. Love that boy.
I'll never know what makes the grass so tall.
Oh, here. It's manure.
What are you doing here? Me want Tom Tom.
Well, that's me. I'm Tom Tom the Piper's son.
This is the consomme. Do your customers like it hot or cold? Pardon? No, I mean, do they like to have it on the table and then... And then do they like to get it off or get at it straight away?
Are you all awful? But I like you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to say how very nice to be back in England once again. I'd like to sing a little song. I hope you like it. It goes something like this. Here we go, Sam.
Look.
I'm praying for the rain in California so the grapes can grow and they can make more wine. F.I.I. in the corner crying a safe little old wine drinkery. I'm praying for the rain in California so the grapes can grow and they can make more wine. I said, little old wine drinker.
What do you do?
I'm a typist.
Oh, and do you do it quickly?
Beg pardon?
I mean, the quicker you do it, the sooner you'll find yourself in a better position.
Oh, you are awful. But I like you.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
What do you know? What do you say? Come in behind me now. I see a great friend of mine, and I love this guy so much. Mm-hmm. I really do. I really take his guard.
You think you're tough. Well, you're not tough. You just smell strong.
Sure.
You just take it from there. Because I see
on my right. Will you shut up?
Yes.
On my right. Here's me coming in again.
Good evening, Mouse. Pete Loudis for this.
Good evening, Fred Litton. Nice and nice and seated and fruit and deep joyed and thrilled.
Ah, good. May I cuddly most of the hornpeckers? Deep joyed.
Oh, oh.
Kissy bone and cheekly.
Oh, Freddy.
Come back, Loudis.
Here right. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, Loudis, my friend Fred Litton, Star Roden and myself, Loudis, we're in a talk getting through the throat, Chris Tooley, about the grand art of cookery at Fannick Craddock and stored it in Frizzy, eh?
This is deep joy, Pete Loud, for this lib-tight fitty for the unloading all ironed and cryy.
Ah.
For the onion mouse days. Now crack up the heck load is dropped down, splatting the mouse on the floor, why before. also, your fun can fall on the slippery mouse of the egg on the bum loader.
Oh. They think it there, and the sold a lemon at bomb famit, and the sorted and over the flame loaded, and by the table.
Oh, suffy mouse.
Coming to see the all at end of gentle forden, a brand odler into the panic cordons, have it high, over down the lappet, and oh, great pain.
Oh, deep. Also, deep joy for this, if you stuffy all the head corners down the throat, cause and all puke in the early morning, this is deep.
Indeed,
this
indeed.
Is nausea acres.
Indeed. Yes. Oh, nausea acres, multifold.
Oh, stinky poop and that's right.
Well, good luck.
Scarlet, I gotta leave town. They caught me gambling with marked cards.
But, Rhett, when did they realize the cards were marked?
When they noticed the Queen of Spades had a mustache.
Aye, here, Polly. You'll be a bit quiet today, matey. Go on, break the silence and speak.
A faith! A faith!
Will you shut that door?
Ah,
Robin, old chum?
Is this far enough?
I think so, Robin.
Shall we start now?
Right now, old chum.
When I'm cleaning...
Windy.
Yeah, 8,000 stinking miles I come. With 6 slugs in me. And all for this. And this safe right here is what I want. Yeah, this safe. This safe is full of cash.
Johnny Cash.
I keep this close watch on this love of mine. I keep my eye wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the time that binds. Because you're mine, I'll walk the line. Because you're mine, I'll walk the line.
Would you shut this door?
White man, speak with forked tongue.
Many buffalo pass this way.
Now the horse song now, the horse, how's the that?
Get down.
Now, beautiful song now from the fabulous, fantastic Miss Shirley Bassey. How's her mother then?
That Shirley Bassey, she's not so much. Take away a slinky gown, and what have you got?
10 years in jail, but it's worth it.
You are awful. But I like you. Okay, big boy. So you think you're going to take my place, do you? You think you're going to replace me, huh? What makes you think you can do that, big boy? What makes you think you can take over from me?
Because I've been working on the prison, see? Are you red?
I like it. Hello, honk-tonk.
What would you see to a little interview?
Hello, little interview.
Well, I mean, I'm interviewing people about holidays. Now, for instance, when do you go on a holiday? Do you camp?
Don't talk shop.
Hiya, my name's Two Gun Rocco. I have two guns because one don't shoot so far.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you've all seen the film Shane, starring Alan Ladd and Ted Loon. Alan Ladd and Jack Palance. I'd like to show you just a little small, not big, just a little piece from this film where Jack Palance comes in to Shane and it goes like this. Thank you.
When I count three, go for your gun. One,
lied about three.
Really, public enemy number one. I'm pretty tough. Mm-hmm. The other day, a cop hit me over the head with a truncheon, and a big lump came up on the truncheon.
Mm-hmm. Listen, kid, Teddy, baby, listen. You did okay as a fighter.
Yeah, yeah. You know, I could have been a contender, Charlie.
Yeah.
I could have had class instead of just being a bum like I am.
Listen, you saw some money, kid, remember? Real money. After your first fight, you were even able to give your girlfriend a necklace.
Sure. It was my teeth strung together.
Budgie.
Yeah, Charlie?
You've been a naughty boy, Budgie.
What do you mean, Charlie?
You've been taking the wrong people, Budgie. Any more of this, Budgie? And you'll bounce, and not with health. Wait for a laugh, Budgie. Wait for a laugh.
Wait for a long time, Ian.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yes, Budgie. You've been a little singing bird, Budgie. A little singing bird. Ah. Ah, Gillette. I don't want the money. It's something else I want, Budgie. It's something else.
What do you want, Charlie?
Sing, Budgie, sing.
Okay.
What do you find if you don't want money? What do you find if you don't want a house? What do you want and a little guitar? Which do you want to keep my love driving? Now which do you want it, my love, Charlie?
Want to tell your friends? Want to tell your? Want to tell your for Budgie Bird? Let's hear it for Budgie Bird.
My girdle's killing me.
Budgie. Come on, Budgie, let's hear from you. What have you got to say, Budgie? What have you got to say?
I'm sick up to here.
And now I'm going to show you how to make dinner for 50 people. Now, first of all, we get, of course, an eighth of an inch of water. Then, of course, we get the brown sugar and just put a touch. Then, of course, we get the egg, which is very, very important because this egg... The egg was important, but it's not so important after all. So, ladies and gentlemen, as all you do now is get half a pound of sugar. And a touch of milk. Silly me. Get down. We add, of course... some raisins. Now the raisins. Now these are very good if you have to suffer at all, if you can't sleep, because... I'll kill that rabbit. I'll tell you what.
Now, of course, we had the self-raising flour.
Let me out!
Stay in. We keep mixing this, of course, with the hands, because this has got to be the right texture. The right texture, because this is very, 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 very important. Then, of course, we have the egg. Now, the egg is very important. Just two eggs will do. Just two, no more than two. That's it. A bit more milk. Okay? More raisins. And add in the box. This is very, very important. In the box. You see, because that gets the right texture again. Then add a bit more water. I've got you. And then more flour. Two more eggs?
I don't care.
Get down! Then a bit more milk. Love the noise of that. And then, of course, we have no more flour, except for this. Silly me. Then, of course, more must be another tub. Johnny, please. Then, of course, more raisins. And this lovely here. Love, that's lovely. Lovely. I love all this, you know. It's really fun, all this. It's all fun. Lovely. It's all coming out. This should make a lovely dish. And now, for the mix.
Not enough.
Who's them?
Harold.
Harold who?
How soon they forget.
Link, friend, Robin.
I'm here, Batman.
Good thinking, Robin. Now, ladies and gentlemen, sometimes you may, or may not, once in your life, suffer. But there's no need to suffer now, because...
Now let's see, you put your hands together for a rage of two continents, Fair Isle and Rockall. Also, Mr. Maxwell.
Him, cheetah.
Straight down the corridor, second on the left.
Come, Cheetah, where is Jane? Jane in the jungle? Where is boy, Cheetah? Where is boy? Boy in jungle. With Jane? Are you sure boy in jungle with Jane? Really sure boy in jungle with Jane?
Would I lie to you?
Now you know why they call me Long John!
Why do you walk alone, stranger?
Having the faintest idea, love.
So come and get it. It's back to the old Cliff Richard.
Come on, pretty baby, let's move it and groove it. Shake it, baby, shake it, honey, please don't lose it. The rhythm that gets into your heart and soul. Let me tell you, baby, it's called rock and roll.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Cliff Richard, and welcome to the show. Oh, I do love me.
Give me the moonlight. Give me the girl.
And one summer's day, they crept in the hay.
Okay, baby, this is it. It's curtains for you.
Johnny, what on earth are you talking about?
I'm talking about you selling me out to the cops, baby. I told you if you ratted on me, I'd choke the life out of you, and that's what I'm gonna do.
Johnny, you don't mean it. You can't.
Oh, no? I mean what I say. I mean what I say, baby. I'm gonna strangle you with this. I found this in your bedroom. Oh, yeah.
Oh, God. My girdle's killing me.
Well, how about it then, Cliff? Well, I must say, listen, you know, I've got a real song now from the bottom, so I'll rather than. Now, you've all a song now from the bottom, so I've got a real song now from the human heart, how's rather than. So I've got a real song now from the fabulous, fantastic Mr. Billy Fury. Guys and gals, won't be a minute.
I want to be your lover, but your friend is all I stay. Don't leave me halfway to paradise, so near yet so far away. I long for your to kiss my lips, but just when I think they may, I'm only halfway to paradise, so near yet so far away. Oh, so near yet so far away. So near, yet so far away.
now it's time for the 9 o'clock news. Today... Today...
Gentlemen of Otterism, Mary, how do, how are. Ladies and gentlemen, standing next to me now at the microphone, I have a wonderful old man. Would you be so kind as to tell me how old you are?
I'm 88, well, friend.
88, isn't that grand? Now, I believe I'm right in saying that you lost an arm on the Somme in 1950.
That's right, Wilfred.
Well, I've got a little surprise for you, because last week, Mabel and I went over there and we found it. So there's your arm. Congratulations.
Don't answer that. It might be a trick.
What do you mean, you dirty rat? You, what do you mean?
We ain't got a phone.
Where are we going?
Sitting Bull's camp.
I know, but where are we going?
All right, Sam, thanks a lot, baby. Ladies and gentlemen, it's nice to be here in your wonderful country. I want to shake my leg, my bone falls right off. I want to sing one more time. Now I'd like to sing my latest song.
Hasn't it been a funny day today?
Aye. Why don't you come with me to the Admiral Bembo Inn?
Tavern!
Admiral Bembo Tavern. It's only 3 miles down the road.
Whoa!
Four miles down the road, we'll have a grand meal cooked by Jim the Chef.
Bill!
By Bill the Chef.
What are we going to have?
Stewed parrot!
Howdy, Bill. My name's Spanish name, Mudley. Come when you're daft. Timber shivered while you wait. Who might you be? The terror of the Caribbean, the scourge of the seven seas, Long John Silver, OBE. OBE? I be fine and OBE.
And that's all. And, what did you do with that?
Well, I'll do with it some. Played it, lad, played it. Now then, what do you think about the Sheik of Araby?
Oh, very good idea.
And a chorus of Tommies. All right. Splendid. Right, here we go then. Right, 2 for 3.
Thank you.
face. You never fear Redskin.
That's right, Ducky. I just go lovely golden brown.
Excuse me. I'm Max Wall, the terror of the Caribbean.
Really?
In the flesh, not a cartoon. Aren't you Long John Silver?
Aye, and that's the R.U.B.
R.U.B.?
I be fine, and R.U.B.
Gotta see my baby again. Don't know where or don't know when. Maybe I'll be happier then on Blue Bayou. And I am Jackson Gay, come what may, on Blue Bayou. Where you sleep all day and catfish clay on Blue Bayou. In a sailing yacht with their sails afloat, your eye could always see.
Tell me now,
what did you want to do? I'm sleepy high, love at me. I'd never be blue, my dream come true.
The bells may be deaf, you know.
Leave these sacred precincts of Notre Dame, you cursed monster.
About 4:15, eh?
I knew you'd say that. I had a hunch about it.
Really, I'd like a pair of shoes, please. Ballet pumps, if you like.
Ballet pump?
Yes.
What size?
Size 9, please.
Big boy.
Wonder what he does for a living.
What colour?
Pink.
When he got black?
Black, then. They came with my feet. That's the little piggy that went to market, you know.
This little piggy's getting none.
You played your cards wrongly.
How those feel, pet?
Oh, I think these are good. I think I could fly in these.
Really?
My name's Professor Karloff. I've had an exhaustive morning pulling up the floorboards of my drawing room. You see, I wanted to wish my first wife a happy birthday. Thank you, Igor. You must excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. I must return to my laboratory. My blood is boiling!
Eventually.
Hello. Tonight I'm going to tell you how to stuff an aubergine. Oops. Johnny's been away rather a lot lately on business, and he misses my stuffed aubergines whenever he can. Well, kill him.
Get down!
I'm not surprised, honey. He sends me, too.
Batman! Batman! How do you conquer Gotham City and conjure good from evil?
It's a little trick. A very clever trick.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, out!
It's not, is it?
Now, although I'm about to sentence you to prison, my boy, I want you to look on the bright side, you understand? One day you'll be free again. You can get a nice job with a computer firm.
But this is 1861. Computers haven't been invented yet, have they?
They will be when you get out, mate.
Do you submit?
Yeah?
Do you submit? Do you submit?
You lock on, do you?
Hey, folks, what do you know? What do you say? Mm-hmm. Hiya. I just shot Capone's right-hand man. His name was Lefty.
Not finished yet.
I shot him with a water pistol on the collar. He shrunk to death.
There's a terrific draft in here.
Well, shut that door.
Hey, do it.
Yeah, Kincaid.
I was just wondering, what happened to that tough guy, Luke McKenzie?
Luke went west, and now he's a ballet dancer who does a bit of interior decorating on the side.
No kidding.
Yeah, he went that away.
So lonesome all the time,
since I've left my geggies behind. I'm glad I am. I got a king, I gave you again. No man, I don't know man.
Checking
ourselves. I'm glue guy in. I'm going back to a game.
Of our discontent, meet glorious summer by this son of York, and all the clouds that lower upon our house.
What's the birdie?
Driver, would you turn left on Bedford? I'll tell you where to stop.
Hey, I told you we were going to the garden, Charlie.
Sure, but I want to cover a bet on the way over. Anyway, it'll give us a little more time to talk. Now, can I ask you something, kid?
Sure, Charlie, you know.
Okay, just tell me this, slugger. Are the Finks, Ginks, and Gunzels in this burg selling straight riff, putting you down for a cheese eater? A rubber-lipped ex-tanker who's walking on his heels and tapping Johnny Friendly and his rib-ups for a quick spritz with loophole gizmos for the shape-up setup.
Well, it's not quite as simple as that, Charlie.
The word on the waterfront, Terry, is that you got some kind of personal prejudice against one of the peers we control through the local.
Now, which one is it, kid?
Yeah, which peer don't you like?
Lord Longford. Terry, if you don't testify about certain people you know, there will be a new job for you.
$400 a week just for roping.
So take the job, kid. Do you hear me? Take the job.
You're gonna take the job whether you like it or not, and keep your mouth shut.
Now make your mind up before we get to 2437th Street. I ain't taking the job.
Stop saying,
hey, Terry, you asked for it!
One, two, three.
I'm a guy. I'm a Steiger counter.
If you don't get back to this one, I'm gonna die. Oh, nobody, no, here, 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 no, no, oh, nobody.
nobody will employ me. Because you know why? I keep falling down on the job.
Walk my way. Walk my way. And a thousand.
Finish the song, Griffin. For God's sake.
Thank you very much indeed, friends. I want to tell you, we have a really wonderful singer here, a young boy. I want to tell you very much indeed. His name is Mr. Gene Pitney. We want to see him. Thank you, sir.
Dearest, darling, I have to write to say that I won't be home anymore. Cause something happened to me.
Hi, guys and girls. It's me, Jimmy Shavo, over here in the again. Hi there, guys and girls. Now, here's the number one song in the country and climbing fast. The artist singing is so great that all I can say is clunk your clinker and hammer the hat and clunk your clunk.
I was walking along, minding my business, went out of an orange colored sky. I hear bang, crash, hail, curse. Wonderful, you came by.
Well, how's about that then? That was, of course, Nat King Kong.
Our friends, thank you tremendously. That was the Reverend Cassius Nabarro and his educated spoons. Now let's meet our next sponsor. How do you do, old son? Who are you?
Well, guys and girls, we have now a top of the pot, so how's about that then? We have now a guys and girls, we have
Is that with two F's?
No, it's with a...
That's really tremendous, old son. And who are you going to introduce to us on the show here tonight?
Well, so how's about that then, guys and girls?
You'll bet. Well, we want to see him. Friends, friends, and friends. Let's have a real... And I mean that most sincerely. Let's have a real Bridlington welcome for impressionist Arthur Mullard, for whom once again, opportunity knocks.
And now my impression of that king of the gangster merchants, Yankee Doodle himself, the one and only James Cagney. You dirty rat.
Tremendously, it's time now to meet our next new sponsor here on our all-newcomer show. He's got a really great new act with a new approach. And that's the end of the news. Here's our sponsor. Excuse me. How do you do, old son? Who are you?
Deep joy, suffering most for this. You see, whole hot peggers on the leg loads and stroke you for this, all nicely before. Oh, yes, deep joy.
Well, that's really wonderful. And who are you going to introduce to us here on the show tonight?
A little boy grown up with singing from the same school from different walkovers and thumbing a hump, hitchhiking and walk down Prospectors again.
Well, thank you tremendously, Mrs. Nabarro. And so, friends, for Arthur Mullard, impressionist from Walworth, opportunity knocks.
Good evening, and hello to all you out there in television land. For my first impression, impersonation, imitation, call it what you will. And if you do, I'll knock your teeth down your front. For my first take-off, the legendary Marlene Dietrich. I can't help it.
I'd like to give you now a little bit of Hamlet by me, as Elvis Presley. This is by William Shakespeare. Thank you very much, Nick. Thank you, Harry. To be or not to be, baby. There's the question. Where 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows and outrageous fortune. Since my baby left, and I'm finding you tailed to death, and it's down at the end of a lonely street. That's so long, baby. You leave me so long. You leave me so long. You could die.
Oh, friends, thank you. The Chesterfield Senior Citizens Nude Formation Dance Team. They were really wonderful, I want to tell you. Thank you very much. Just give a little rub down, she'll be okay. Friends, I want to tell you now, let's see who our first sponsor is tonight. Thank you very much. Thank you. Good evening, madam. Tell me, what's your name?
Well, first thing, my name's always present on the first thing in the same dude, baby. So I want to say it.
Oh, that's really wonderful. In a jumbo jet?
Well, that's all I want to first thing. I just want to shave my legs, baby. That's the first thing I want to do.
Tell me, who you going to sponsor tonight?
Well, yeah, first thing I want to do is I want to shave my left eyes. I want to be honest with my eyes. I want to first thing.
Well, that's really wonderful. And what does he do?
Well, it's one of us. One of us. Or me. I just want to care about it. It's the first thing I want to see.
He does impressions.
No. Well, that's one of us. And the swastika is not laughing.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, to Mr. Arthur Mullet of Bilston, Garden City, Opportunity Knocks. We want to see him. Let's hear it, Frank.
Good evening to all my fans of my takeoffs. Hi there. For my first skit tonight, here is my impression of that tough of the silver screen, Cary Grant. Judy! Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Look, don't go there to pages. You run off with my wife. Can I borrow your horse?
Okay, but it'll make a mighty poor substitute.
Yeah. very much. Thank you indeed. I want to tell you, really wonderful, for a 24 stone color achura soprano, Mr. Ted Bates from Little Lambton. We want to thank you. See you next week, Ted. See you next week. That is if the discharge comes through. A little joke, friends, a little joke. I want to say. Well, friends, let's meet our first sponsor for tonight. Tell me, monsieur, who are you going to introduce to us tonight?
Hey, well, it's like that, here. Aye. It's all right, it's about that now. It's a good player, aye. Aye.
Oh, that really is a good player. Yes, he really is, yes. And tell me, who you're going to introduce again tonight?
Well, you see, what about that nice little
Oh, that? Oh, of course, yes, of course, yes. Oh, I'm sorry about you.
It's one about that now. Thank you very much, Shane.
And what's he going to do for us besides that?
Impressionist advocate. I think I was all right. Oh,
we've got an impressionist on the show. Well, friends, for Mr. Arthur Mullard of Lima, Peru, Opportunity Nights.
Hello, everyone, and my lord worshippers everywhere. My first impression tonight, the man who became a lifetime in his own legend, the immoral Charles Laughton, as Quasimodo, the Hunchback of Notre Dame. The bells. Those bells are driving me bleeding mad. Thank you.
Thank you. We are some ants and scans on the dust on the flash. So it's on the dick, man. Man of uns. In 1, 2, 3, 4, stick your finger in your ear.
Captain Silver, sir, I've just found a beautiful girl stowaway in hold number 3.
Well, send her to my cabin, and I'll show her hold number 4.
Shut up! I'm just an old-fashioned girl with an old-fashioned fence.
And he says, excuse me.
To speak to the world-famous ballet dancer, Rudolf Boryoff. Mr. Boryoff. Good evening, Mr. Boryoff.
Good evening.
Would you like to take a chair? You know, you came to this country from Russia. Now, when exactly did you defect? What made you start dancing in the first...
place?
Was it seeing other male dancers? Mr. Boryoff, I believe... I believe many years ago your father was caught by the Cossacks. Well, thank you for being so frank. Mr. Boryoff, Bali is very... very demanding. Very physical. I mean, all the moves you have to execute. What's your favourite position? Well... finally, could you tell us what you most like about the ballet?
It's the money, innit?
Freddie Starr. He's a man with many personalities. Meet them all on the Freddie Starr Experience. Saturday at 10 on Plus.
How's about it then? How's about it then? Beautiful song now from Total Pop. So how's about beautiful song now? How's about it then? So how's about beautiful song now from Colour Pairs? How's about that? And Spinner.
Thank you, Cliff.
Thank you for listening. Ladies and gentlemen, how's about that then? For who is it?
Ruby Keeler.
Ruby Keeler. Thank you.
Get off your horse and drink your milk.
Hey, Mush! Give us half a bitter, will you? And give us a full one this time, and I'll put one on you.
Excuse me, sir, but aren't you Noel Coward?
Yes, yeah, right, yeah, yeah.
Then why are you talking like that?
It's me say off, innit? Me say off!
Now, Tarzan as Frankie Vaughan.
Give me the moonlight, give me the gun, I leave the rest to...
This is the point in the program where I introduce a note of culture. And I'm just the man to bash it to you. I'm going to do my funny walk now. That's me doing it over there. I'm doing it quite well today, because I ate up all my breakfast like a good boy.
Could you sing the next one, Janet?
Oh.
It's you, Angus.
Hey, hey.
You want me to examine you?
Please, hey, hey, hey.
Put your right leg up.
Hun?
Put your right leg up.
Up where?
Just up here. Put your left leg up. How long have you been having these dizzy spells?
Hiya. What do you know? And what do you say? I just shot two guys. A flat foot. And a private eye. I got the eye in the foot, and the foot in the eye.
Thank you, thank you very much, thank you. Now, for my first trick tonight... Oh, what am I shouting for? I got the job. For my first trick tonight, I need an assistant. Can I have an assistant, please? Any assistant, anywhere in the room. Thank you very much, thank you.
Governor of this place is the meanest, nastiest governor of any prison in the world. Who else would put a drawing pin on the electric chair?
Ladies and gentlemen, we have Rocky Gazlano here, right here. Rocky Gazlano right here. Ladies and gentlemen, before he gets in the ring, here at Madison Square Garden, ladies and gentlemen. Now, we're gonna ask a few questions to Rocky Gazlano, ladies and gentlemen. Rocky?
That's my name.
Rocky, how many fights have you had?
336.
336?
Mm-hmm.
How many were lost?
336.
How come?
Me a coming them all.
You know what I like about you, baby? Me and you, we're two of a kind.
Yeah, I know what you mean. You dirty rat, you.
That's good. Keep it in. Speaking to you now from the heart of the African continent. I'm about to interview this gentleman. None other than the immortal ape man, Tarzan. Now tell me, Tarzan, I understand that you've just taken out a very famous woman on safari.
That's right, love. Gladys Feversham. Lovely girl.
Really?
She shot 12 lions.
Goodness.
3 leopards and 1 rhino.
You mean you took Gladys, Lady Gladys Feversham, out and she shot all those animals?
Yes, she did.
Quite a bag.
Oh, you know her then?
Hello. Tonight I'm going to make crepe Suzettes for you. As you can see, I already have my plates warming in the oven.
Here's a deep joint and introduce loudly Mr. Professor Stanley Unwoden and speak it into through the Throcus and out it in the nudist campus.
Oh, well, deep joy for this in the early morning when the bird load is whistling forth from the Throcus as well.
Oh, I see.
Now, as you know, the sportiest games in the nudist camp, like shuttlecocky.
Yeah.
Also, for the female species they play netball, this is bouncing off the bladder, chuck a hoopalo down. Dropping bangly buzzing.
And here's a warnitin for though, and the rhododendroders and the holly bushes.
Oh, neckly mouse on the bum load.
Oh, yes.
All right, send in my next patient, please. Thank you. Excuse me, do you need psychiatric treatment?
No, it's the wife. She's a bag of nerves.
I've lost me nuts!
There's no answer to that.
Hey there, you with the stars in your eyes.
Yeah.
I'm going to give you a simple test we psychiatrists call association of ideas.
How do you mean handsome?
Well, I'm going to say a word to you, and I want you to answer me with the first word that comes into your head.
Mm.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Very well. Shoes.
Men.
Table.
Men.
Sky.
Men.
Look, do you associate men with absolutely every word?
Oh, no. Try me on spaghetti.
Yeah, all right. Spaghetti.
Italian men.
Things that you say and do makes me want to be with you. Oh, rave on, it's a crazy feeling. And I know it's got me reeling. I'm so glad. You're the only rave on for me. Rave on, ooh, rave on, tell me not to be lonely. I'm so glad you're relieving your love of me. Rave on, tell me you're not to be lonely. I'm so glad you're the only rave on for me.
Harlow, what do you think you are doing? What do you think you are doing now?
Don't let it happen again.
Honestly, Johnny, I really don't know what to make of you.
Hello again. If you remember, we were making a hummingbird hips of Laragrech. And now it's time to taste it. They are really wonderful. I love these here. Perfect.